Well, hello and welcome to Climber Bushcraft. Yeah, it's a wonderful day. You can see the sun is shining, but there's also a forecast that says it's going to rain later this day. I'm back out in my camp and I have some things I will show you. I'm just repairing my little reindeer fur skin here. I don't know why it's cracked, but I'm going to sew it together. And beside that, I have a project I would like to share with you and some other stuff. And I also have a very happy announcement to all you, my wonderful subscribers. So hang on. This is the new bag I made, and I would like to show you in detail what it is and what is inside this
bag. This little bag made of leather and a piece of antler here, I made this week. I think it's very nice. And inside, yes, I have two things. This one and this one. My Svea stove. Yeah. It's a bag for my Svea stove, and this stove is using fuel, and in this it is actually a flask that can be used for many things, whiskey and cognac and so on, but I decided to use it for the fuel I'm going to have in this Svea stove. I just put a little leather around it so it can be recognized that this is not drinkable, but for the stove. And why I chose this was because it fits nicely here, you can see, so that way I could make a little bag for it that was compact. So, and in a moment I'm going to make my coffee using my Svea stove, but before that I would like to show you a little video where I make this bag and how I did it, and I hope you like. Yeah, and now it's time for coffee. Oops. A little bit of this gasoline down here, because this one has to be preheated. And I think I'll see if I can light it with my ferro rod. Yeah, there you go. Find the right place, there, yeah. And when this flame, this preheating flame is dying out, I'm going to light the gas, or the, I think it's called white gas, when it's gasoline. This preheating makes the pressure down in the canister so that the gasoline will come up and be ignited here up, and be ignited here. Yeah. I hope you like my little video with my DIY project. I think it's become out good. I think it's nice, and now I'm going on my vacation to Norway, and then I will take this one with me. So now I just see. Yeah. So now some
Yeah, and yesterday I was out paddling my canoe, and I have a little story I would like to tell you about that experience. I was eager to come out and get some practice with my new dual paddle, as you saw in my latest video, and also my old paddle of wood that I have seen some YouTube videos of how I am going to do it. I'm not doing it right, I know that, and many of you kind subscribers have told me that, but I'm learning. And well, it was a windy day yesterday, and but it's good weather. The sun was shining most of the time, and I thought, well, the river was down below ground level, so I didn't thought that it would be very windy out there. But I went out to this little river where I've been before, the Lindholm Å. Å means river or creek in Danish. And I decided to paddle down the stream, and it was a wonderful experience. You can see here I'm smiling. It was a great day. I had the wind in the back and the current with me, so there was no trouble there. It was just cool, and I could practice my two paddles. After a while, about 20 minutes, I decided to turn around and heading back home, and that's when the trouble started. It was so windy that I almost couldn't fight the wind, and if I hadn't had my dual paddle, I don't think I would have come back to the car with my solo paddle, because I never experienced such a wind before. I could feel that it was the canoe, the wind was taking the canoe, and as you can see here, in a turn at the river, the currents and the wind almost blew me over to the other side. So I had to struggle a lot to come into the river again in the middle and continue that. So 20 minutes out, and well, about 45 minutes back, and I really was tired when I came back. So that was a new experience for me, and I was glad I stopped at that moment, because I had actually planned to paddle a lot longer, but I thought, well, this wind, perhaps it can give me some problems, and it sure did. So now I, next time I'm out, I know how I'm going to behave in those situations. I talked with some other guys out there that was out with their kayaks, and almost every person I talk about this river, they say they always sail downstream, because the upstream is very hard, and together with the wind it was quite a challenge. But now to the final thing. Yes, some of you maybe have noticed yesterday I turned the 50,000 subscribers. Yeah, it's amazing. I can't believe that. It's taken a while to get here. The last month has been very slow, and actually in the last couple of days, or perhaps last couple of weeks, I actually lost some subscribers. I think that my canoe videos are not so popular, and some are telling me that they like my canoe videos, but they prefer my video from Kimber Camp and the forests. So I will not make a lot of these canoe trips, not right now, because I think that's what most people like, me out in the forest and here in Kimber Camp. So but now I'm turning the 50,000 subscribers, and of course I going to make that giveaway that I promised you, and I won't write it in this video, because I only want you, my faithful subscribers and viewers, to get a chance to win these three awesome prizes. Yeah, I have three prizes for you. And it's because when I write, or when one writes a giveaway in the video description, many people from that are not subscribing to my channel are trying to win these gifts. And I think you that have been with me for so long and faithfully watching my videos, you should have opportunity to participate in this contest with not so many people.
And these are the three prizes you can win. Grimfrost has generously donated this, a drinking horn and a belt holder, so you can have it in your belts. It's an awesome drinking horn, very Viking style. Actually, I have one myself, and there can be a lot of mjöl, or beer, in this. So the lucky winner of this will definitely have a challenge to drink a good toast, a skål, together with me. So Grimfrost made this donation, a wonderful drinking horn, and a holder so you can have it in your belts. And PNW Bushcraft, my old companion there, are again donating a wonderful thing for me. It is the ground cloth. You see me used it in many of my videos. You can use it on the ground, so you always be dry when you sit down. Even if the grass is wet, it will keep you dry. And I also use it in my tripod chair, my Viking chair, as I have shown you in some of my videos. It's an awesome product, and PNW Bushcraft think that they will donate that for my giveaway. So thank you very much for that. And the last thing is this boon. This boon that I carved some time ago, I'm donating this in my giveaway. It's made out of birch tree, and it's a very special design. I like it very much, but I have so many spoons that this one will be the third prize in my giveaway. The one from Grimfrost and PNW Bushcraft will be sent to you directly, and the spoon I'm going to send to you from my personally. So, now, what are the conditions? Well, I would like you to be a subscriber for my channel. I can't check if you are, so I'm depending on your honesty, and I know you will not disappoint me in that direction. So you have to be a subscriber, and then you have to write in the comment section, "I'm in." You can write other things too, but you have to write, "I'm in." And in a while, because I'm taking on my journey for Norway in a couple of days, and when I'm getting home, I have to make some other stuff. So the 23rd of July, I'm going to make this draw for my giveaway. I'll write it down here. And then the three lucky winners will be chosen. Oh yeah. There was some other stuff I would like to tell you. What was that? Oh yeah. Because I'm going on my vacation, I can't answer all your comments. So in this video description, you can write what you want. I will read all your comments and make a little heart so you can see that I have read it. But I can't answer your questions and comment your comments. So I hope you understand that. And I'm looking very much forward to see, first of all, how many of you who are watching this video would like to win one of the prizes, and secondly, the three winners. I'm sure it will be a great pleasure for all of the winners to receive their prizes. So good luck to everyone. Yeah. Yeah, and I actually had planned to take my canoe with me to Norway, but we decided, my wife and me, that not going to do that, because that's a lot of reasons. But when I have it on top of my car, I can't open my back door in my car, and that's always a lot of things we have to get out there. And beside that, I haven't made a second seat for my wife yet. I'm going to make that. I have the seat, but the fittings was not available now, so they will come when I get back from my vacation, and then I will mount that, and then my wife Gitte can take with me on some trips, and I'm looking very much forward to that. But I'm sure it will be a great journey to Norway again. I really enjoy traveling that country, and I've looked out some places where there's some history about Vikings that I will try to find and perhaps make some videos there. I'm not sure if I'm going to upload a video during my trip, because if I don't have Wi-Fi, it will be in a very bad quality. I tried that a couple of years ago, that was no good. But perhaps if I come to a campsite where there's Wi-Fi and I can make a little video, I will upload it to YouTube so you can see how my trip is going. So I hope you'll join me on this, and of course I'll make a lot of footage from my trip. I also have my drone with me, and I'm looking very much forward to make some awesome drone footage from Norway. And when I get back home, I'll of course make a video so you can see how my journey went. Yeah. Well, I'm going back home now, have to edit my video and begin to pack my stuff, so we can, this all have to fit in my car, and we got a lot of stuff with us. All my bushcraft gear almost take half the place, half the room in the car, so yeah. And we have to have all our, have some beer and soda and food with us, because now it's very expensive. Everything is expensive up in Norway. So we bring a lot of stuff. Yeah. So I'll say thank you for watching Kimber Bushcraft. I really appreciate that. And I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.